What we learned this week is that that whole question of too big to fail, whether it was Citigroup or Bank of America, too big to fail, any institution in America apparently was too big to fail because they pushed all this money into private corporations and foreign banks and you name it. I don't know if your website, michaelsavage.com, got a bailout, but Monica Memo certainly didn't.
No, and I'll tell you something else. In my book, Trickle Up Poverty, I have a big chapter on the Wall Street nightmare, the meltdown. And I allege, and I think I present all the evidence to prove, that the entire financial meltdown was orchestrated. It was orchestrated to cause a panic. The panic was then, as you well know, set up to force many Americans in the middle to bolt and to vote for anyone new who was Obama. The entire crisis was planned, and it was set up strictly to put Obama in office. And the people behind it, I think, can be found on the pages of Trickle Up Poverty, and I'll name some of them. The Managed Funds Association forced Bush to alter the so-called uptick rule, which I won't describe here, which permitted them to raid financial institutions, raid the stock market with these incredible hedge fund manipulations, with fiduciary instruments that never existed before. And in so doing, these pirates of Wall Street wrecked the economy, caused the havoc, caused the panic, and gave us Obama. And that's what we have right now. And I've proven in Trickle Up Poverty. And Monica, you know, the book sold about 135,000 by now. That means about, they say, what, three people per each book? If you sell a book, I think three people read it. So almost 500,000 people have read my book by now. And I believe that it had a lot to do with the midterm meltdown of the Democrats. People are not that foolish. They know what's going on. And they're also not too happy with the direction the government is taking right now. Here we have Pelosi and Reid in the middle of the night, coming back and pushing the radical left-wing agenda as hard as they can. The Republicans are not resisting as hard as they can. The Republicans are only resisting, I would say, to just maintain their base, but they don't really give a damn about the voters as far as I can tell. Yeah, there may be a hardcore of Republicans who understand what the message was, but by and large, I believe the K Street gang is going to do just what they did before Obama came to power, meaning just what they did while Bush was in power. It's business as usual. It's terrible.
You recognize the voice, of course, the one and only Dr. Michael Savage, radio superstar all over the country. In fact, you can go to his website, michaelsavage.com, find out where you can hear his show near you. His huge new bestseller is called Trickle Up Poverty, Stopping Obama's Attacks on Our Borders, Economy, and Security. Michael, I want to take a step back for a second with you and ask you a big picture question. Where are we in America today? I mean, we just talked about the bank bailouts and too big to fail and duplicity on all sides. We talk about the failure to have consequences for failure in this country, whether you're a kindergarten kid who gets a prize in dodgeball even though you've lost because nobody wants to make you feel bad and protect your self-esteem, all the way up to the CEO of Citibank. Oh, we can't have you fail. Here's a prize. Mm-hmm. Here's $1 trillion of government money. Where are we in America? Have we lost our way? Are you optimistic, pessimistic, and what can we do about it?
Well, I tend to be a pessimist with a tinge of optimism, or as I said to someone last week, I'm a glass half full kind of guy, not a glass half empty. I really don't know whether we can recover from this because there are certain elements in our society that never existed before. The large influx of non-English speaking illegal aliens, for example, who refuse to desire to assimilate, I think pretty much predicts where this country will be in 10 or 20 years. You know, I am the son of an immigrant. I respect immigration, but I don't respect people who come in here illegally and won't learn the language, wave the Mexican or Nicaraguan flag, and jeer those who wave the American flag. And I think that tells us where we're going to be. And the only solution would be for us to have a Winston Churchill arise from the mass of politicians that we have who are not leading us right now. The most dangerous threat to our survival is national security, the enemy within, the fact that our Homeland Security Department sees the average American as a potential terrorist. But when they look at the radical Islamic terrorist, they won't even define them as terrorists. They won't use the I word. They won't use the M word. But the average American, your grandmother perhaps, an old man in a wheelchair, is considered a suspect every time he wants to fly a plane. I think the government is upside down. It's Alice in Wonderland. It's going to take almost an act of God, Monica, for the country to be saved, and it's going to require some kind of extraordinary individual to arise from the unknown masses to save us. That's what I have the hope for.
Do you see him or her out there?
Well, they're right on this show. You and I could save America, that's for sure.
A Savage Crowley ticket, 2012? What do you think? Are you down with that?
I'm not a politician, but it wouldn't be bad. I can guarantee you we could do a better job than Obama's doing. And Mitch McConnell.
About 1,000 times better, Savage. What are you kidding?
And probably a little better than Mitch McConnell can do, the gobbler. I mean, for God's sakes, these people are like professional politicians. They don't even know what the word America means. All they know is what their party stands for and what their special interests stand for. When did America go out the window? Yeah, I don't know who the individual might be. I think that the individual has been born. I think the individual may be fighting in Afghanistan. The individual could be a school teacher, for all I know, or the individual could be in Congress right now. I don't know, Monica, but I'm in that regard, on a day-to-day level, I'm sort of pessimistic, but on a cosmic long-scale level, I actually am quite optimistic.
Final question for you, Michael, and then I'll let you go. It does seem that there are two real levels of fear out there among our fellow Americans. The first level of fear is immediate and urgent about the economic situation. Am I going to still have a job? Will I ever be able to find another job? Is the bank going to foreclose on my house? But I think that there's a more profound fear that's percolating underneath that first level of fear, which is that the very soul of America is changing. And that we are essentially helpless to stop it. I think the Tea Party is a movement that's trying to stop it. I think some Republicans up on Capitol Hill and those who were just elected get it. But I think it's such a tremendous deep-seated worry of most Americans that I think you are going to see a tipping point coming sooner rather than later. And that's why I'm optimistic.
You are an optimist. You see that? I drew that out of you, Monica.
Yes, you did.
I drew your optimism from the depths of your despair.
Only you could do that, Michael Savage.
Okay, well, you see that? We had a productive session today, didn't we?
Now, we always do.
I will be booking you for further therapy. Please see my secretary on the way out.
You come really cheap, too, which is why I love our therapy sessions.
I knew you were capable of I knew you had fangs after all is said and done.
Love you, Michael Savage. You are wonderful. Thank you so much for doing this with me again. It's always a joy to talk to you.
Thanks, Monica. Really appreciate it.
You bet. The great Michael Savage. Check out his website.